Hi students, this is Karthik Trivedi and you are watching a lecture series of engineering graphics and design with me. So in last video, we have seen the different types of instruments which is required in engineering graphics and design, and also we have seen the different types of line and their importance. So in this video, we're gonna see the first, what is dimension. Second, we're gonna see methods of dimensioning. Third, we're gonna see align system. And fourth, we're gonna see unidirectional system. Not only that, we also gonna see some subtypes of method of dimensioning, like parallel dimensioning and chain dimensioning. But first, we start this video with the first question, that what is dimension. So let us read first the definition, which is on your screen. So dimension is the numerical value that is being assigned to the size, shape, or location of the feature being described. So we got to know three things. The dimension is numerical value. The first thing that we got to know, that dimension is numerical value. Second, this numerical value is assigned to either size or shape. And third, it is also assigned to the location of the feature being described. So we got to know three things. First, it's a numerical value. Second, it is assigned to the size or shape. And third, it is also assigned to the location of feature described in the figure. So now we will understand these three things with one example. So you can see one figure over here, and you can see the various dimension written over there. You can see the dimension 20 written over there. You can see dimension 15, dimension 60, 33, 17, 8, 22, 30. These all are the dimension is assigned to this particular figure. Now in this figure, you can see one circle over there, and the diameter of that circle is shown by a little line and written a diameter, or you can say that is a written a symbol 5. Symbol 5 is used for showing the diameter, and then written 20 over there. So 5 20. So what it shows? It shows that this object contain a one circle, and diameter of that circle is shown by the dimension line, or you can see the little line, and written 520 over that. That means this circle is having a diameter of 20 mm. So first, you can see that all the dimensions are numerical value. So first thing, that all the dimensions are numerical value. So you can see that all the dimensions are numerical value in the figure. First thing. Second, it is assigned to the size or shape. You can see there is one circle over there. So we have assigned the dimension to that particular circle. Or you can see there are various edges over there. Or you can see that there are various, you can see the center line over there, or you can see that the circle is at particular distance from the right side. So what we have done, we have assigned the dimension to the size and the shape. So first thing, you can see that the circle is over there, and we have shown the dimension, or you can say we have shown this, the diameter of that circle, by a little line and written 520 mm, though 520 mm over there. So what it shows? It shows that this object contains one feature, and that feature is circle, and that circle, the dimension of that circle is shown by a little line and written 520 over there. That means this circle is having a diameter of 20 mm. Also, if you look at this figure very carefully, the center of this figure, if you see the center of this figure, or you can see if you can see the center of this circle, if you can see the center of the circle in the figure, you can see that from the right hand side, the center of the circle is at 30 mm, it is at 33 mm distance. So you can see that 33 mm is written over there. So what it shows? It shows that the center of the circle is at a distance of 33 mm from the right hand side of the drawing. So second, it shows the location of the features. Okay, so now from this figure, we got to know that the dimension is a numerical value. Second, it is assigned to the size or shape. And third, we get to know that it is also assigned to show the location of the features being described. Now we're gonna see the second thing over here. Now second thing we're gonna see is methods of dimensioning. So there are various methods of dimensioning, but there are major two types in that. So first is align system, and second is unidirectional system. So first we're gonna see what is align system. So now, as you can read the definition on the screen, they are placed perpendicular to the dimension line such that they may be read from the bottom or right hand side of the drawing sheet. So first, in align system, dimension can be read either from the bottom side of the drawing sheet or it can be read from the right hand side of the drawing sheet. So in Align system, there are two views. First one is bottom side and second is right hand side. Second thing that they have written over there, these dimensions are placed at middle and top of the dimension line. So dimension is going to be placed at middle and top of the dimension line. So let us understand these two things with one figure. So you can see there are various dimensions written in this figure. You can see the 30, 20, 50, 10, 16, 28, 60 and 516. These all are the dimension which is written over here. But you can see that all this numerical value, or you can see that you can see the dimension 20. Now let us see the dimension 20 in your figure. So you can say that the 20, which is numerical figure, which is written at the middle and the top of the dimension line. You can see the 20 is at middle and top of the dimension line. Same way 50 is at middle and the top of the dimension line. As same way you can see the 10 at middle and top of the dimension line. Same way you can see 30, which is at middle and top of the dimension line. Same way all are the dimensions which is numerical value, which is at the middle and top of the dimension line. So in Align system, the dimensions is written at the middle and top of the dimension line. And second thing, they can be read from the bottom side or right side of the drawing sheet. So you can see 20, 50, 10 and 16 mm diameter, which can be read from the bottom side. So you are viewing from the bottom side. So when you view from the bottom side, you can write 20, 50, 10 and 16 just like that, which is also shown in the figure. Now if you give the dimension, or if you can view the dimension from the right hand side, so the dimension which we can view from the right hand side are 30, 16, 28 and 16. And just look at this very carefully how they are written. So when you see from the right hand side, so 30 is written exactly as it is seen from the figure. So students make mistake when they are assigning the dimension from the right hand side. So look at this figure very carefully, and when you are giving the dimension from the right hand side, you have to give it just it is shown in the figure. So see this figure carefully and keep this thing in your mind. So you can see from the right hand side, we can view 30, 16, 28 and 60. So if you write a dimensions from the right hand side, or you can view, if you are going to view the dimensions, or if you are assigning the dimension from the right hand side, then you have to write 30, 16, 28 and 60 same as it is shown in the figure. So now in the summary of this system, we can see that in Align system, the dimensions are written at the middle and the top of the dimension line. And second, the dimensions can be read from the bottom side of the drawing sheet and also from the right side of the drawing sheet. Okay. Now, the next system is called unidirectional system. So let us see the definition. So dimensions are placed in such a way that they can be read from the bottom edge of the drawing sheet. So here the only view from which we can see the dimension is the bottom side. So in unidirectional system, you can only view the dimension from the bottom side only. Second, the dimensions are inserted by breaking the dimension line at the middle. So now see this figure to understand these two things. You can see all the dimensions in your figure: 30, 20, 50, 10, 16, 28, 60 and 16, which is written over here. You can see all the dimension is at the middle, inserted middle, not middle and above. But you can look at this carefully. All the dimensions, or you can say all the numerical value, are inserted in middle. Okay, not middle and top, but in middle. So you can see the 20, which is inserted in middle. You can see the 50, which is inserted in middle. You can see the 10, which is inserted in middle. You can see the 16, which is inserted in middle. You can see the 28, which is inserted in middle. So numerical value is inserted in middle of the arrowhead. So this is the first property. Second thing, that you can only view this dimension from the bottom side. So that's why you can see that the 30, you can see the dimension 28, 16, 60, all are can be seen from the bottom. So they can be assigned, they can be assigned same like as we have assigned in the figure. So this is how you can assign the thing. You can see the previous figure. Yes. Now pause this video and see the dimension, how I have assigned the dimension by Align system and how I have assigned the dimension by unidirectional system to this same figure. And by comparing these two, you will get to know that how you are able to assign the dimension by Align system and unidirectional system. Okay. Now we gonna see the subtype of methods of dimensioning. So it is called chain dimensioning. So in the chain dimensioning, all the dimensions are aligned in such a way that the arrowhead of one direction touches tip to tip the arrowhead of the adjacent direction. Now see the figure. You can see the dimension 12 written over there. Now you can see the dimension 12 and their arrowhead. And now you can see that just besides it, or just adjacent dimension is 8. So you can see the arrowhead of the dimension 8 and the arrowhead of the dimension 12 touches each other tip to tip. Now you can see the other dimension 50. It is in the same way. You can also see the 12. So what I can say, the chain dimensioning is a respective dimensioning. You can see the all are having a respective dimensioning. Okay, so 12, 8, 15, 12, 55. So here the dimensioning is given such a way that the one arrowhead of one dimension touches tip to tip the arrowhead of the adjacent dimension. You can see from the figure, the arrowhead of the 12 touches the arrowhead of the dimension 8. Same way, the arrowhead of the dimension 8 touches the arrowhead of the dimension 50. Okay, so this is how the chain dimensioning is given, or you can see that this dimension is given with the respective dimensioning. Okay, now the other subtype is called parallel dimensioning, or you can say progressive dimensioning. So here in parallel dimensioning, all the dimensions are shown from a common reference line. So let us understand this with one figure. So you can see this one figure over there. There are a dimension which is written 12, 20, 35, 43 and 55 over here. But if you look at this figure very carefully, that this all distance 12, 20, 35, 43 or 55, or you can say this all dimensions are given from the one common reference line. And you can see that these all dimensions are given from the left hand side, or you can see the from the left extension line. You can see the 12 is given from the left side of the drawing. The dimension 20 is given from the left side of the drawing. Dimension 35 is given from the left side of the drawing. Dimension 43 is given from the left side of the drawing. And dimension 55 is given from the left side of the drawing. So these all are dimensions is given from one common reference line. So that's why this dimensioning is called parallel dimensioning. So in this video, we have seen what is dimensions, what are the different types of dimension, what is aligned system, what is unidirectional system, and also we have seen what is chain dimensioning and parallel dimensioning. In next video, we can see what is scale. I hope you like this video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.